Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. My name is Monica and today we're going to be doing an empties video. I think I've only done one or two empties videos on this channel so far. I was planning to do them fairly regularly, but I never tended to accumulate enough stuff to do them whenever I wanted to, so I kind of just let things pile up. So I do have a good mixture here of skincare along with makeup. Instead of splitting it up, I thought I would just go through all in this one video and just do like skincare first and then end with the makeup, though I don't have too many makeup empties. It's mostly skincare. So before we jump into the video, don't forget to give this a thumbs up if you like empties videos, and if you want to see more, don't forget to let me know down below in the comments. And while you're down there, subscribe at the little bell icon so you're notified whenever I post a new video. So let's start with the one obvious thing that I have the most of. Let's count these. Okay, so I have 7 packets of the regular Neutrogena makeup removing cloths. I have 2 of like the mini travel size. I did buy a big box at like Costco, so it came with a bunch of the full-sized ones, and then you got 2 mini ones just to go with it. And then I have 1 empty of the night calming version, which this one is my absolute favorite. I wish they sold these in like the big boxes at Costco, because I would buy like 20 of them. You also don't have to get them at Costco. You can find them at Marshall's. I found this one at Marshall's and it was $3.99 for the packet. These are my favorite way to remove my makeup every day. I just take a cloth. Normally they're not like, once I get to the bottom of a pack, they're not completely soaked with product anymore. But at the bottom, because I like to store them upside down in my drawer. So I will store them upside down just so that all the juice kind of flows to whatever one that you're using like currently. But once you hit the bottom, you're gonna run out of some juice, so I just add a little bit of water to it. I take off all of my makeup except for my eye makeup. I do use a either micellar water or a, we'll go into that a little bit later because I do have a couple of empties in here for that. But I take off all of my face makeup, I take off my eye makeup separately, and then I go in with my face wash every night. Currently I'm actually trying out a new one that I just found. They make a hydrating one now, which I think is really cool. It does smell a little bit different than the rest of the cleansing cloths, but it's supposed to cleanse and remove makeup, even waterproof mascara. I haven't seen a huge difference with performance from this one to the other one, so I think my favorite is still the purple packet, the night calming one, but this is still a good option. I still think this is the best line of makeup removing cloths that you'll find. The next empty I have is a micellar water. This is the Bioderma micellar water. This is my favorite way to remove eye makeup. It actually melts everything off and I don't have to scrub. This is one of the only micellar waters that I don't have to scrub my makeup off with. So I just put a little bit onto a cotton round, just hold it on my eye and then wipe, and then everything's gone. I also use this to remove whatever I have in my eyebrows for the day. It is a little bit pricier than what I was currently using for removing my eye makeup, but I honestly think it's worth it. You can find this on Amazon. I also found it, I have a Riley Rose in my local mall, and they sold like the big tub where you can actually, what's the cap, where you can actually just take a cotton round and go shush, shush, and then it'll actually put it on the cotton round. I found one of those, so I got one of those, but you can find the small bottles on Amazon. If I can find a link, I'll see if I can link it down below. But this is one of the best ways to remove eye makeup and I love it. Next I have a toner empty. This is the Neutrogena alcohol free toner. It's not my favorite toner, but it was always available. I ran out of my favorite toner and since then I haven't been able to find it anywhere, and so I'm a little upset about that. But this is, it gets the job done. I like the way that it feels on my skin and it definitely tones. I like to take off my makeup, wash using my CeraVe cleanser, and then I go in with a toner. These are fairly affordable. I always get them at CVS so I can use coupons or get like CVS cash, what's it called? The cash bucks back. But it is really good if you have combination skin because it doesn't make your dry areas too dry, but it also helps like control your oily areas. So it's a good option, it's just not like my number one favorite. Next, I have 2 empties of the Measurable Difference Vitamin C Serum. I love this in the morning after I tone. I do put this on before my moisturizer. I adore this serum. I can only find it, well, I can find it on the Hush app, but it's twice the amount of money that it is if you buy it from TJ Maxx. So whenever I go to a TJ Maxx, I will scour the skincare section looking for these little vitamin C bottles. And when I find them, I'll buy as many as I can find because they are $6.99. and a bottle will last you a few weeks if you use just a little dropper every morning. I love the way this feels on my skin. It sinks in really, really fast, and then I can go right in with my moisturizer. So I have two empties. I currently have two on backup that I bought a couple weeks ago, I believe. Right now I'm testing out a new vitamin C from The Ordinary. Not really liking it as much because it's not a liquid, it's more of a cream. Not a huge fan, but I'm gonna finish it up, and when I finish it up, I will go back to this vitamin C serum. Another product from The Ordinary that kind of missed the mark for me was their Grand Active Retinoid 2% Emulsion. I was testing this out to see if it could be a dupe or like a replacement for my Sunday Riley Luna Sleeping Oil, and it did not do nearly as good of a job. As I said before in my skincare videos, that oil is the one thing that I will splurge on because I've seen the biggest difference in my skin just by using that retinol oil. This one didn't really do a whole lot. I think I actually purged a little bit more using this one. I used the entire bottle and I was still purging at the end, so I don't think I purged the whole time. I think it was just my skin doesn't like this product. I think it was too raw for my skin because it really is just 2% retinoid emulsion. With the Luna Sleeping Oil, you've got your retinol, but it's suspended in the oil, so it's not as like harsh on your skin. So while this one was cheaper, it didn't do as good of a job. Wouldn't repurchase this one. I have an empty of my favorite moisturizer. This is the Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizing Lotion. I go through these like water. I always buy mine at Macy's because my family has a Macy's card, so we can use those to rack up some points and get some discounts. You can also find them at Sephora, but I find that I do like to pick it up either from Ulta or from Macy's just because the rewards are a little bit better. This one is for very dry to dry combination skin. They also have a gel version of this that works well for more oily skin, but with my combination skin, I do lean a little bit more towards dry in the summer. So this moisturizer is really good for me, and I've been using it for years now, and I keep repurchasing it. Love it. So two little samples that I tried out. I think I got these in subscription boxes. The first is the Belief Moisturizing Eye Balm. It was an eye cream. It was just okay. I used up the entire sample, but I didn't see a huge difference under my eyes. I've actually not been using a cream just for under my eyes recently. I was using a cream and it just felt too heavy under my eyes. I feel like I could try to find a cream that I could use at night, but I feel like at this point I don't really need one. I've been using the Luna Sleeping Oil, so I don't really need, I feel like I didn't need that extra step in my routine. And this one just felt like an extra step that I didn't really see a whole lot of difference from. Next, I have the Green Clean Makeup Melt Away Cleansing Balm by Pharmacy. This one is just a, it's just a makeup remover that comes in like a solid form, so you would like double cleanse with this. I love the idea of these, but until I can find a nice drugstore version of this, I can never get on board because you go through them so fast. Like the one from Clinique, I love, but it's like $30 for a jar. And you go through that in under a month if you're using it every day to take off your makeup. That's not sustainable. That's way too much money for a makeup remover. So until I can find a good drugstore version of like a makeup removing balm, I'm not gonna really be on board. Okay, moving on to makeup. First, I have like a fake empty. This is a Rimmel Stay Matte Powder that I tried to depot. These things are so fragile. I really don't like the packaging, so I thought I would try to depot one, and the whole thing crumbled. Crumbled and it fell everywhere. So I'm glad these are really affordable. I do love this powder more than any other drugstore powder out there, but packaging for me was just a little bit tough to get by, and it's so hard to depot. If anyone knows a good way to depot these, please let me know because I'll keep trying, but I don't want to keep wasting money. But I also don't like the packaging, so it's like a catch-22. But it's a good powder. I would highly recommend this one if you can find it. Next, finally an empty, I have my Chantecaille mascara. I absolutely adore this thing. I actually bought a full size. I did. It was a couple of weeks ago. I haven't opened it yet because I still have a little tub of mascaras that I have to get through. But I do have a full size. I will open it up at some point. But again, I am going to follow the 3-month rule. I have a couple of mascaras in there now that are open. They're small sizes like this. They should be done by the end of July, so I'll swap out my mascaras then. Don't know if I'm going to jump right into the Chantecaille because I have a couple others that I want to test, but I do have the full size waiting, and it's because I loved this smaller size so much. Next, I have a clear brow gel from ABH, Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is actually my favorite clear brow gel. I've been testing out a couple of other ones, and I find that like the shape of the actual like applicator itself was so helpful. I don't know what it is about that. I think that's the perfect size. It's not too big, it's not too thick, and just it just made putting gel on so much easier, because now I have a couple other gels that I'm trying and the bristles are so big that I'm actually taking off some of my makeup around my eyebrow just trying to put it on, and I never had that issue with ABH. So it is a little pricey, but so far it's been my favorite clear brow gel. I'm gonna try out a couple of others, maybe do a video on them, but I do really recommend the ABH brow gel. Another older empty that I've had for some time is the Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder, and this is the shade 10. I used to love baking with this. This is such a good loose powder at the drugstore. Super affordable. I think it was like, it was $10, around $10, and you got a lot of product. It took me a long time to get through this tub. It is so finely milled. It is so comfortable. It makes your concealer just sink into the skin, and it doesn't budge throughout the day. I don't get like as bad transfer from my like I don't get transfer from like my mascara or from my eyeshadow down below my lower lash line. Just love this powder. If I didn't already have a couple of other loose powders I'm testing out, I would have bought this one right away. I was actually tempted to buy this one again, but I have so many powders that I really don't need to. But it's a really great powder. Highly recommend you try it out if you haven't already. It's just so good. Next, this one's a little bit of an older empty as well. This is the Ulta Full Coverage Liquid Concealer in the shade Light Warm. I actually have two backups of this because they always do the Ulta brand, like buy two, get two free sales. So I bought a couple of brow gels. They have the tinted brow gel. I tried to find the clear brow gel the other day, but they were sold out, like totally sold out. I really want to try that one out and see how good it is. So I also got a couple of concealers for free along with that. So I have those in my backup drawer. If you guys want to see a video about what's in my makeup backup drawer, I saw Angelica Nyquist did a video on that and it was really interesting. So if you want to see my backup drawers, let me know down below, because I think that'd be a really fun thing to go through. Anyway, sidetrack, we're back on topic. This is one of my favorite concealers, and for the most part, I don't like a whole lot of drugstore concealers other than the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define. This one is just such a good concealer. It is full coverage. It actually is full coverage. You only need a little bit. It took me a long time to get through this concealer. It's affordable, and like I said, Ulta always does these sales, buy two, get three free, because it's part of the Ulta House line. Love this concealer. I already have backups of it. Would definitely rebuy again. Highly recommend you try it out if you haven't already. I also have a MAC Fix Plus empty. I don't keep these with my regular empties just because I am trying to back to MAC. If you can see behind me, I actually have over here that MAC bag. That's actually hanging up on my wall. I keep all my MAC empties in there so that I can remember to keep them all together and not recycle them, so I can bring them back to MAC, because we do recycle, so all of this goes straight into like my recycling bin downstairs, so that stays separate so I don't forget it. And my last empty are some setting sprays, and they're both from Skindinavia. I have the little mini and the full size of the makeup finishing spray. I always end up with the minis because I buy this setting spray when it goes on sale, and if you sign up for their email lists, they like always go on sale, and you can get like 25% off, and you get the two minis and you get free shipping. So whenever I see that, I buy another one, because it's less than a setting spray at Sephora, but the quality is like sky high. I love this. I believe it's the exact same formula as the Urban Decay setting spray, just because Skindinavia, I think, not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure they supply for them. It's just like you're buying directly from the supplier, so the bottle's a little bit different. But this one's really good. I've actually bought another one already that I'm using right now. As soon as I finished this one, I got the other one out. It's a different type of spray though. This one's called the Makeup Finishing Spray. I think I have the Makeup Finishing Spray Bridal Edition. I saw that and I thought it was interesting. Wasn't sure like what the big difference was. So I am testing that out now, and I will let you guys know how that goes. But I do absolutely adore these Skindinavia setting sprays. They also have a makeup priming spray. I don't like that one as much just because I'm not a huge fan of spray primers, but I've heard great things about that one too. Oh, I think we did it finally. We went through all of the empties, a lot of skincare. I don't tend to go through makeup as fast as I do skincare. And I think I was trying to do alternating videos of makeup and skincare, but since I had so much skincare, I was waiting to do the video. So I think whenever I do empties, I'll just throw them all in one video like this. Let me know down below if you've tried any of these products, what you think about them, and what your last empty was. Let me know what your last empty was. I think that's fascinating too. Like, do you remember the last thing you used up? Thank you so much for watching, and I hope I'll see you in my next video. Bye.